Hey USA, this is Movies on JAG. Each week, we bring you exclusive clips, trailers, interviews, and of course, your opinions on what's coming out in theaters. This week, we have Brooklyn's Finest. Have y'all heard of the movie Brooklyn's Finest that's coming out?
I think I've seen like the name on the internet, not like briefly, but I don't know anything about it.
I have not.
You haven't?
I've heard of it, but I don't really know a lot about it, so.
No, never. What is it about?
BK Project. Highest crime area and the highest crime precinct.
Watch where you walk.
Watch your mouth.
Blink, blink, blink.
One cop struggling to keep his cover.
These cats I know uptown, they want to buy from us.
Ain't sound real confident.
I trust them, man. I wouldn't even come to you with this unless I did.
Set it up.
I want my life back, Bill.
And I'm working on it.
Don Cheadle plays an undercover cop that keeps trying to find a way out, but he can't seem to find one. Check it out.
How's Alyssa? Your wife. Oh, I'm sorry. That's soon to be ex-wife, right? Get out. Get out.
It's all right. Thank you. Just give us a minute, please.
I heard she's remodeling your house. On a cop's salary, huh? You know, a whole lot of cash has passed through your hands over the last 2 years.
I ain't stole so much as a nickel since I've been on the job. You ain't got...
Oh, you do not want me to put a microscope up your... Because if I do, I will keep looking until I find something.
Until you plant something?
Watch that. Now you listen to me. You think you're a tough guy? Because you did undercover at Clinton Correctional? You even survived a little incident there.
If you know so much about me, and you got a case, bring it. But until that time, step off. Dude.
One cop desperate to support his family.
We're expecting twins. You need a new house.
I don't have all the money.
No, that's not a problem. The situation is complicated, that's all.
Ethan Hawke plays an emotional character that's trying to find a way to support his family and his pregnant wife that's expecting twins. Take a look at the clip.
This is our house. We belong here. Look at this right here. You have a little pool for a little turtle for Mr. Vinny. Right over here, you have a little garden for Vicky. And in here is a kitchen. You've seen the kitchen, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this kitchen's going to knock you out.
Sal,
got this fridge.
Sal, no, I believe you. Sal.
No, you don't believe
Sal.
Me.
Sal, you tell me this guy's purple. I'm going to believe you, okay?
Like. Go to the doctor today?
Yes.
Yeah, what do you say?
Yeah, I feel worse, you know, and I should feel better. I do. It goes on and on. It's just...
Well, you're still not telling me what you said.
Yeah, I know. Because you know why?
Why?
Because I got dizzy. Twice.
Oh, you're getting dizzy spells? You're getting dizzy spells and you're not telling me?
A little bit.
And you cannot do that. You gotta tell me. Okay, because it's the... mold, all right, in these walls. That's what it is. You know it is. It gets your asthma. It goes into your lungs. No, baby. No. You need a new house. I'm calling Mrs. Vincent right now.
Sal, I don't need anything. I really don't. Just you, babe.
No, you need a new house, okay?
Somebody needs to take care of you, and that somebody is me, okay?
One cop just trying to get by.
Don't you want to do something useful with your last 2 minutes on the job? Here's the deal. Our commissioner, he believes in this new program that puts rookie cops in the highest crime areas. So they want seasoned hairbags like you breaking these recruits in. And since you're the oldest here...
Look, if it's all the same to you, I got 7 days. I'm no one's teacher. I'm not a role model.
God knows you're not, Eddie. But your name came up in a computer, pal.
This thing's been kicked up by 2 months, and all eyes are on it. Just do the best you can, okay? Come on, Dugan. Don't you want to do something useful with your last 2 minutes on the job?
Not really.
It's gonna be all right, I promise you.
They got millions of dollars sitting in office, all drug money. Far be it from me to wag my finger at somebody who's looking out for himself.
What are you doing?
How much longer are you gonna be dodging bullets, man? These streets got an expiration date on them.
It's just good to know we got some real fam out there, man.
You do this, you got detective first grade.
He
retires in a few days.
Shield, you're done.
We're all imperfect creatures. And we're led to sin. Pray for forgiveness.
Have you seen the movie Training Day?
Yes, I did.
Yes, I saw Training Day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Did you see the movie Training Day?
No.
Hold on, you didn't see Training Day back in the day with Denzel Washington?
No.
What? God, man, it was awesome.
See, Michael, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
Said it, we are. You can call me Caesar in a dark Caesar. Please follow the leader.
Do you think with the same director directing Brooklyn's Finest, do you think that'll influence your decision to go see Brooklyn's Finest?
Yes, I do, because the way he set Training Day up was really wonderful.
I think it's going to be based on street, like real life street events. And I'm hoping that it's going to be something to go see. You know, it kind of goes towards the hip-hop culture, and I just hope that it's going to be a good movie.
With the Oscars fast approaching on Sunday, March 7th, let's see who you think should take home Best Picture this year.
Avatar.
Blindside, just because it's, I don't know, everybody's into the whole drama, sports drama.
I think most likely Avatar.
Either Avatar, I think that was it was a great movie. It had a lot of romance, and I kind of liked the romance side of it. And also Precious, because I think it showed another side of America. But it was great, it was great actors, and I really loved those two movies.
I feel like it's Blind Side will.
The Blind Side to win, but Avatar is going to win.
Avatar will. That's what I think. Avatar.
I hope The Blind Side wins, but I bet Avatar will probably win.
The Blind Side.
It was so sweet. It made me cry.
Hurt Locker. Awesome movie.
I like Inglourious Basterds. Definitely that's the best movie out with Quentin Tarantino as director.
Are you going to watch the Oscars this year?
I'll try. Probably not.
Probably not. I'll probably be too busy with school and everything.
Probably not.
I might watch it for the first time this year. I don't know. I might do that, though.
Maybe.
That's all we have for you this week. We'll see you in theaters for Brooklyn's Finest. But look for us next week on campus, where we're going to be giving away 2 tickets for the screening of the original Boondock Saints. If you can't find us on campus, be sure to check us out on our Facebook fan page, where we'll have a trivia question to give away 2 more. Next week, the numbers will all add up when we take you inside the comedy She's Out of My League.
Why would she ask me out?
Are you nervous?
Yes.
This Molly is a hard 10. Meanwhile, the guy's a 5.
I'm Laura Piper. This is Movies on Jag, and that's a wrap. What was the last movie y'all saw in theaters?
I just went and saw Shutter Island, actually.
What do you think about it?
It was good. The last bit of it really redeemed it. Like, for a while it seemed like it was going to go downhill, but at the end he really picked it up and managed to avoid a cliche. I thought for a moment it was really heading for a cliche, and then he saved it at the last minute.